During the 1980s, my radio room was at the fourth level of a block of houses. I could not use a conventional dipole antenna. The feeder towards the center of it was impractical. So a long wire was installed at about 8 meters above ground level. It caused strong noise reception from all houses around, heavy feedback in the microphone, modulating the gas flame height of the central heating appliance, and two floors down, a CWing refrigerator, clocking noises in radio and TV, interference in TV pictures. Modifying the long wires to a Zeppelin antenna did help only a little. Using a long and wide metal rain gutter as a ground capacitance helped only a little. Extra feeder length wound 30 times on a 50mm PVC pipe did not solve the problem. So how to get rid of this RF? The construction of a coaxial dipole antenna solved all problems, and its radiating properties also were excellent. I always was one of the loudest 100 watt 80 meter stations in the Benelux. Unbalance and common mode are bad things. The feeder and everything connected to it becomes a part of the antenna system. The mains net power too, causing RF on the feeder. A distorted antenna radiation pattern. RF in your radio equipment. RF in your house. RF in the neighbors' houses. Reception of strong noises from the house, mains wiring and environment. On the left is a vertically polarized VHF coaxial dipole antenna radiating horizontally towards the horizon. The coax feed line runs coaxial through the center of the lower quarter wave radiator part. It is insulated by air, thereby perfectly decoupling the feed line from the radiator. The antenna cannot induce radio frequency currents on the feeder. Noises on the outside of the feeder cannot enter the antenna nor the receiver. This feeder-to-radiator decoupling system is sometimes called a bazooka. The upper radiator part is only connected to the center conductor of the coaxial feed line. The lower radiator part is only connected to the screening of the coaxial feed line. By turning such an antenna 90 degrees, it will radiate vertically towards the sky and to the Earth's surface. But constructing an 80 meter bent coaxial dipole with 20 meter long metal tube as one radiator half is unpractical. The problem of the air insulator and the coaxial radiator half can be solved by use of both skins in the coax screening and a high Z wideband common mode choke over the coax. The schematic of the Cobra shortwave coaxial dipole. The radiation pattern of the horizontal coaxial dipole. The feeder and the house are in direction of the minimum. Nearly no coupling between radiator, feeder and the house occurs, resulting in very small common mode currents. The common mode choke. RF currents run in a very thin layer on the surface of metal conductors. These layers are called skin layers. At the screening of a coax, two skin layers exist. The inner skin and the outer skin. As RF currents are running in very thin layers, both skins are isolated from each other. The transport of RF energy between transmitter and antenna takes place inside the coax. Two currents flow there. One on the central conductor, the other on the inside skin of the screening. Both currents have equal amplitude but are 180 degrees out of phase. This is called the differential mode circuit. The sum of both currents is zero. this circuit is perfectly balanced. As a result, no RF power will be radiated. The outer skin of the screening is not balanced, and RF currents there will radiate power. This is called the common mode circuit. Common mode radiates energy. A common mode choke with 17 turns, 2.5 mm Teflon coax on a 29 mm MiX-31 core. It shows about 7 kOhms choking impedance at 4 MHz. It should handle up to 400 watts in a well-matched 50 ohm system. A common mode choke with 21 turns 5 mm Teflon coax on a 61 mm MiX-31 core shows about 11 kOhms choking impedance at 3 MHz. This choke should handle up to 800 watts in a well-matched 50 ohm system. As Teflon coax tries to unwind itself, the first and last turns must be fixed in place using tie wraps. Two or three of these chokes connected in series should function well in a coaxial dipole antenna system. Bifilar chokes also perform well in coax systems. This choke is wound with 16 turns of a pair of 1.5 mm electrical insulation wire in parallel on a 61 mm MiX-31 core. Its choking impedance on 4 MHz is 9 kOhms and its characteristic line impedance is about 90 ohms. The air cooling is good and it can handle up to 700 watts power. Both wires must be wound in parallel, without twisting, in one direction. Keep the winding ends short. As the length of the choke winding is shorter than 2.5 meters, it is small compared with the half wavelength on the lower shortwave bands. The mismatch in a 50 ohm system due to the 90 ohms choke impedance is therefore negligible. A common mode choke can be represented by a parallel schematic. LP is the choking inductance, CP is the winding capacitance, and RP the choke loss resistance. Manufacturers often use a series schematic to show choke properties in an XY diagram. RS is the loss resistance, GXS is the loss-free choke capacitance or choke inductance. When using a ferrite core as a common mode choke, RS and GXS will be induced in series with the common mode circuit of the transmission line. Placed over a coax cable, RS and GXS are inserted in series with the outer skin. GXS is the inductive plus capacitive part of the choke set. A common mode current I will not generate losses nor heat in GXS. RS is the pure resistive part of the choke set. It represents the ferrite losses. A common mode current I will generate losses and heat in the ferrite core. The losses in common mode chokes. Common mode power loss is I square times RS. When the ferrite loss resistance is large, the current is small and the power loss is very small, resulting in very little heat generation in the ferrite core. Choose ferrite with losses as high as possible to keep the temperature rise in the ferrite core as low as possible. The differential or cable losses cause only temperature rise in the copper inside the core hole. A graph retrieved from the ferrite catalog. The shown ferrites are usable for common mode chokes in the black indicated frequency ranges. Mix number 43 and mix number 61 ferrites are not usable for common mode choke purposes in shortwave antenna systems. MIX number 31 ferrite is especially designed for that purpose. It can be used in the whole shortwave range up to 32 MHz. The power of N square. When a transmission line passes N times through the hole of a ferrite core, the ferrite core loss resistance RS becomes N times N larger. Inductance LP and winding capacitance CP will also be larger. As a result, the resonance frequency of the choke shifts downwards. Common motor chokes connected in series. The combined choke impedance will be higher. The combined bandwidth will be wider. The RF current I through both chokes will be smaller. The I square times RS losses will be quadratic smaller. These losses will be divided over all chokes. Each choke will experience lower power loss. Two identical common mode chokes connected in series will theoretically allow up to 8 times higher maximum power to the choke combination. At the top, the frequency characteristic of a common mode choke, made with 14 turns RG58 over a 61mm DIA MIX 31 core. By connecting two of these chokes in series, the choke set and the choke bandwidth will be larger. When winding thicker 11mm coax, 70 times through a bigger 101mm MIX 31 core, the maximal allowed power is higher. This choke impedance is about 9 kΩ. Two chokes wound with different number of turns can widen the choke bandwidth further to higher bands. This high Z power choke contains three chokes connected in series. The dipole center. At the open end of the screening, about 3 cm inner insulation should be left extended. It must act as a high voltage insulator between coax screening and coax central conductor. Mechanically connect the coax onto the polyester rope by using black tie wraps which should go through the rope, thereby preventing slipping sidewards along the rope. This 40-meter long antenna in a Z-shape was successfully used by an amateur who had a too small garden. Compared with an earlier FD4 antenna, he received far less interfering noises and performance and standing wave ratio on 80 meters were good, although the antenna only had 5 meters height above ground and partly run over the house. Half-wave common mode transmission line resonances cause high common mode currents and voltages. These will result in RF in the radio room and the house, strong reception of noises from surroundings. Install over the feeder every 6 meters a common mode choke, made with ferrite snap-it 19mm hole MIX 31 cores. Start at the antenna tuner. Wind 5 turns RG58 or 16 turns RG316. You also could wind 14 turns RG300 at the bigger 61mm ring core. This proved antenna ID deserves following up. It is a better solution than a commercial NFET antenna. Do you not have enough surface or length? Then install it in a Z-shape. Or make a shorter version, but always symmetrical. For most frequencies, you already had to use a tuner. Yes, it costs effort.